Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
All right, hello everybody. This is Tom Martell bringing you a little Theros Block 8-4. And for those of you who've watched me stream, you may recognize my my co-drafter here. I'm joined by the one and only Susie. Susie, say hi.
Hello, everybody.
So we're going to do a little team drafting and then play some magic. So yeah, we will kick this off as 8-4. All right, here we are. We're off. Interesting first pack. I think we have a couple of the better commons in the set in Feast of Dreams, which is probably the best black common.
And Foil Feast of Dreams.
So we do have a choice.
Slightly a better black common.
A choice there. And then also there's a Hubris, which is one of the better blue commons. It really depends on who you ask. Opinions are pretty divided on Hubris. Mm-hmm. I know Pantheon, we were not that impressed by it. We thought it was pretty underwhelming, actually, relative to our initial expectations. I know that, for instance, the Canadians, Alexander Hayne, thought it was the best blue common. So opinions are very divided on this card, but... also competing here, we have one of the better rares in the set, Spawn of Thraxus. A very powerful card, but has the drawback of being red.
Yes.
Which is an unfortunate drawback in this set.
I know how you love being red.
I do not. I do not like red. And for this, red is like a gambit, much like the Gatecrash Guilds were in full Ravnica block, where you the hope the person on your left cooperates. Because red is so much better in Pack 2 that you need it to be open then. So here I think there's a couple other fine cards. I mean, Stonewise Fortifier is a perfectly good 2-drop. But really, for me, it's between Spawn of Thraxus and Feast of Dreams. I really like black a lot. I don't like red that much, but I...
Click Feast of Dreams.
I'm going to take the Feast of Dreams.
I'm glad you did the foil one. And here we have a Spiteful Blow.
Right, so actually, no matter what we'd first pick there, would be actually a great option in this pack. Had we first picked the Dragon, we'd be taking this Forgeborn Oreads. Mm-hmm. And we first picked Feast of Dreams like we did, we're going to take Spiteful Blow. And if we first picked Hubris, we would take Warbring Siren. So all three of them are getting a pretty good follow-up here. Hopefully the person to our left will take that dragon and then we'll follow up with the Oreads and we'll get out of our way. We're looking to draft probably, ideally, black-white or black-blue are my two favorite combinations with black. And that leaves them with a lot of options in terms of where they're going to go with their red deck. But we'll definitely go ahead and take Spiteful Blow here. Mm-hmm. Spiteful Blow is a significant improvement over the former 6-drop.
Sip of Hemlock?
Yep, exactly. Sip of Hemlock. This is much, much better. Which is a nice improvement. Blowing up a land, you can color screw your opponent, you can mana screw your opponent, you can do a lot with that.
How do you feel about Squelching Leeches?
I like it a ton if you're in mono black. It's extremely powerful, but I really want to be able to table it here. Mm-hmm. For me, this pick is really between Bloodcrage Hoplite, Golden Hind, and Pinned to the Earth. I think those are the three best cards. Magma Spray too, but...
Right, we've already passed two really good cards.
Exactly, there's no reason to go into this now. So, because again, we want Red to be open in Pack 2. I typically don't really care about signals and what I'm passing to the left, or what I'm signaling, except in this set, I care if I'm signaling red. So I'm going to stay out of red entirely. Here, I think, could be Goldenhide.
I like Goldenhide.
It's the best common. I really pin to the earth because I like to be blue-black control. That's mm-hmm. my preferred archetype, but Goldenhide is just a much, much better card. And I think you have to take it over, you know, cards like Bloodcrazed Hoplite, cards like Magnus right here. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to take the Goldenhide. I do like green-black quite a bit as an archetype. I think it's fine. I like it a little bit less than black-blue, but not a lot less.
Here we have Satyr Grove Dancer.
Yeah, so this pick is between Satyr Grove Dancer and Warring Siren.
The second Warring Siren you've seen.
Yep. And I think here, I mean, I think Warring Siren is definitely a better card, but we already have black and green cards, no reason to take a blue card. Just going to go and take the Satyr Grove Dancer here. Worth noting, you know, had we been red, we'd have another good follow-up here in Flurry of Horns. Our red deck actually would look pretty good. Mm-hmm. But
the person to our left
is hopefully enjoying that and hopefully sticks there and we can cooperate nicely. We'll probably get punished by opening the Mythic Phoenix in Pack 2, is my guess, just to really punish us for not taking that dragon. When the magic gods give you a dragon, they don't like it when you...
when you pass the dragon.
Yeah, when you don't respect that.
So here we have a Present and a Swiftclaw. Neither one fits really what we're trying to do.
Right, I mean, definitely the best card in this pack is Johnny's Presence.
Right.
I mean, for us, it's Cast into Darkness or taking a white card. When I draft black-white, I typically like it to be a control deck, you know, abusing cards like Scholar of Athreos in Pack 3. Although you can easily splash Scholar of Athreos in your green-black deck because there's pretty good fixing in green.
Right, you want to splash the white, not the black.
Exactly, that's the half of that card you want to splash. So here I think I'm actually just going to take Cast into Darkness. It's fine in a control deck, it's fine in an aggro deck, both halves of it, you know, the shrinking of the power or the can't block piece can be very relevant. Mm-hmm. So I think it's just a fine pickup here. Worth noting, there's a Storm Chaser Eagle, excuse me, Storm Chaser Chimera.
Wow.
This card's good, but it's in blue-red, which I think is significantly the worst color combination. I know a few people, I mean, most notably, Christian Calcano has become, loves blue-red, but I don't think he knows what he's talking about, so I'll keep passing the cards. Hopefully, I got to my left. I'll go blue-red, and we'll all be happy.
I think he has a different outlook than you.
He does. That is true. Yes, I'll go with he has a bad outlook. I'm kidding, of course. Love you, Calcano. Yeah, so here, I mean, pretty clearly, just Spire Spine. Mm-hmm. It's obvious that he has to block with only one toughness, but you can often trade up. He, you know, he'll basically trade any creature that's on the ground. And that bestow ability is really sweet with four power, because if they're just tapped out, you can just haste them in for a lot of damage. So I think this is really easily the pick here. You know, Market Vessel is a fine card, but not something you want to take highly. Passing another kind of late fortifier, so we are seeing some good white cards here, but a little bit too late for us to move in. It is worth noting, black looks pretty cut. We've only seen... Been past the Spiteful Blow.
Yep.
Easy Consigned to Dust here.
Yeah. We're seeing some pretty late red. Again, I think that ship has sailed.
Yeah, definitely not going to take any red cards now.
Far out to sea.
And here, I mean, just to take a Humbler of Mortals. I mean, green does feel pretty open. We got this third pick Hind. You know, we got late Spire Spine and a late Consigned to Dust, which are both good cards. So green feels very open. Maybe we'll end up not being black. Are we able to splash this Feast of Dreams? And go something like green-blue, which is a color combination that I really like, depending on what we see in packs 2 and 3. Definitely not wedded to this black, but I think we're just going to take the Humbler Mortals here.
Okay, more green.
Our pack comes back to us, and there's still the Renowned Weaver and the Golden Hide Ox. I don't like this card very much. I know other people think it's decent. It does trigger Constellation on their turn, which can be nice if you have Constellation abilities that are relevant. But we don't have any of the green guy who pumps power.
Also triggers Dictate of Erebos.
Also true. It is very clear to Dictate of Erebos. But here I'm going to take Golden Hide Ox. I mean, we don't necessarily want to play that many sixes, but they're both, I think, pretty reasonable. And having options there, I think it's better than getting this Renowned Weaver. It's just a card that I've not been impressed by.
Font?
We'll take Font. I actually really don't like Font of Fertility. In our testing, when we were preparing for the Pro Tour, we thought this card was much worse than it looked. But it's a free pickup here, and if we want to end up splashing, it's nice to have. What does this thing do? Okay, nothing. Blank. Blank card. Font of Return versus Font of Fortunes here. I think Font of Fortunes is a lot better than Font of Return, although green-black often can exploit the graveyard nature of Font of Return. But
we haven't gotten any of the 1-1 black Death Touch guys.
We don't have any of the black graveyard stuff, and I don't think black's been open, so there's a decent chance we end up moving into blue. And so I'm going to set that up now by taking the more powerful Font of Fortunes there. And here I'm going to take the Dictator Crucifix. We're not going to play Return Reveler in this deck. And I'll actually take a Desecration play for my sideboard over another Return Reveler.
Doing anything to avoid the Reveler. And we did not table the Leeches.
The Leeches, yeah, did not table. So, which, given how little black we saw, it's not surprising. I mean, the person directly to our right could easily be heavy black and just took that Lose Leeches 8th. Mm-hmm. Or maybe they went sooner than that and someone took them 5th or 6th as an upside pick. That would not surprise me at all. Mm-hmm. I think after pack 1, our deck is certainly not that exciting. I mean, we have a Golden Hind and a Feast of Dreams, which are both good. But after that, it drops off pretty quickly.
Strike Barbie,
Sword
Rise
Centaur. Yeah, also Aerie Worshippers and Nyxborn Trident in blue. Right. So some decent blue cards. For me, this is really between the Strike Harpy and the Sword Rise Centaur. Mm-hmm. If I knew for sure we were going to end up staying black, I'd probably take the Harpy. But I actually think I'm going to take Sword Rise Centaur here and try to be heavy green. I don't think the card is actually all that much worse than the Harpy. And I think it lets us try to be a more aggressive green deck. So I think I'd rather take the Centaur here. Just because we know we're green, and I want to get my colors sorted out.
So there's a lot of green here to choose from.
Yeah, tons of green cards. Rare missing, so we're pretty unlucky here in that they opened a pack that only had, you know, a Kragma Butcher and a Servant of Timuret and a Forlorn Sudama here. I mean, this is an obvious Servant of Timuret to me. It's one of the better black commons in this set, and you know, we maybe are still black. I mean, it's probably the most likely outcome, so I think we'll take Serpent Pim right here. Although I'm definitely disappointed by this pack. Less disappointed by this pack. I mean, we're seeing a lot of red coming through still. We have a couple pair of Kragma Butchers, but I guess that's not a lot per se, but seeing a decent amount of red. For me, this is just a pretty clear Grave Robber Spider. A good defensive creature. We will probably have some black mana to activate it. I could see taking Nyxborn Eidolon here. I don't like taking Forlorn Sudama here, but I think this is just definitely a spider pick. And then there's this pack. Yeah, these packs are not really firing all cylinders. I mean, Skyguard's the best card here by a lot, but obviously that's not where we are positioned.
Right.
I mean, it's just a mortal result for us. Actually, this is a pretty good trick. It leads to a lot of blowout scenarios, which I like.
Right. The indestructible is kind of priceless with, say, our Spire Spine.
Right. Oh, absolutely. It's great with the Spine, but it's not a card I really want to be taking this early. But, you know, beggars can't be choosers.
Right.
They can just be beggars like we remain in this pack. We're seeing the white common run, both still here. So this is Unravel the Aether versus Snake of the Golden Grove.
I think Unravel the Aether.
I would normally agree with you.
We have a consigned to dust.
Yes, we already have one consigned. Although I do like that they're both instants, and I like that Unravel can take out gods. That's pretty sweet. So I think I will take Unravel over the Snake. Snake's pretty replaceable.
I just think big monsters are really easy to get in green. And you're
that is
a
true. Wolf is great, and this is very happy to get this, you know, get this displayed. Wolf's one of the best green commons in the set, and just you know, good at 3 mana, good on bestowing, does a lot. And you can say the same thing here with Noble Quarry, pretty easy pickup as well. Some thought for the Nyxborn Triton. If we were certainly blue green, I'd probably actually take Triton over Quarry. But here, you know, we're green X, and we already have a Feast of Dreams and a Spiteful Blow. Versus and a Servant of Timuret, you know, likely to be green black, so I'm just going to take this Noble Quarry. Ooh, that's a gift. Happy to pick up another one of Sword Rise Center this late, rewarding us for being heavy green. Also setting us up to go into pack 3 and, you know, pick up green devotion cards like you know, Nilia's Disciple was going to give us a lot of life in this deck.
Right. Help us. Reverend Hunter.
Yeah, Reverend Hunter would be awesome here too. So I think this is a pretty easy Sword Rise Center. And then I'm actually taking Area Worshippers over Marshmas Titan. We just talked about how we're green devotion, not black devotion.
Right.
So even if we end up being black green, we're never playing this Marshmas Titan. Whereas if we end up being green blue, say we open Prophet of Crufix,
sure.
And we just slam it, then we're going to want this Area Worshippers for our deck. And then, none of these cards are playable.
This pack.
Yeah, nothing here is really playable.
Wow.
These are both, I mean, actually, this is Aspect of Hydra. If we were definitely green blue, I would take Sunstorm, but I think Aspect of Hydra is actually good in this deck. Double Swordway Centaur, you know, we have a Golden Hind and a Grove Dance, we have a lot of cheap green creatures. This is going to be +2/+2, +3/+3, at least. Could easily be more than that, so I'm actually going to take Aspect here over an insanely, insanely late Sunstorm.
You've convinced me.
And now let's pick up a Drifters. This is a random body we might want. Cut this Hold to Bay. Pick up another Drifters. Alright, so after two packs, our deck's looking okay. Not exceptional by any stretch, but I mean, we are green, and we are probably black, but maybe blue. And maybe white when we open Elspeth.
Yeah.